friends. Welcome to Mariners Kids Online. I'm so excited that you're here with us today. Now, let's jump into some worship to kick us off. Let's go.
One, two, three, four. Yeah, you were there, cause Jesus has always been there, right? You changed the course of history, nailing our sins upon a tree, Word of God. Yeah, you were there. No love can compare. You are the good news, good news. You are the dents in my shoes. You're the way, you're the truth. You're the lie. You are the good news, good news. You are the God I will choose. You're the way, you're the truth. You're the lie. This good news is mine. Here we go! Jesus, you're alive.
All right. You conquered death.
You conquered death so I could live. You clothed me with your righteousness, Word of God. Yeah, you are here right now. You know the hairs of every head. You'll never leave is what you said, Word of God. Yeah, you are here always.
Get down real low. You guys ready? Are you guys ready? Here we go. You ready? Here we go.
You are the good news, good news. You are the dance in my shoes. You're the way, you're the truth, you're the light.
A little more. Here we go, a little more.
You are the good news, good news. You are the God I will choose. You're the way, you're the truth. You're the light.
Get up, get up, get up.
You are the good news, good news. You are the dance in my shoes. You're the way, you're the truth. You're the light. Oh, 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 oh. You are the good news, good news. You are the God I will choose. You're the way, you're the truth. You're the light.
You're the way, Jesus.
Back to Mariners Kids Bullet Train Express, a ride we know can change our lives. I'm your conductor, Angela. I cannot believe we are here at the end of our journey, the final station to Easter, the empty tomb station. It has been a pleasure being your guide as we have visited the Garden of Gethsemane station, the trial station, where we saw Jesus being unfairly sentenced, the cross, where we saw Jesus following God's perfect plan. And of course, the Palm Sunday station, where we praise Jesus for being God's perfect and ultimate plan. Now, hold up your ticket and join us on the Mariners Express as we enter into our next station. Join me as we say, for the final time, all aboard!
On the third day after Jesus' death, Mary Magdalene went to Jesus' tomb. It was still dark, and she saw that the large stone at the entrance had been moved away. Mary ran to Simon Peter and John. "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and I don't know where they have put him," she said. Peter and John ran to the tomb. John looked inside and saw the linen cloths lying there. Then Peter went into the tomb and saw the linen cloths too. The cloth that had been around Jesus' head was folded up. John believed that Jesus was alive. Then Peter and John went back home. Mary went back to the tomb and cried. When she looked inside, she saw two angels sitting there. They said to her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "Because they've taken away my Lord, and I don't know where they've put him," she said. Then Mary turned around. Jesus stood in front of her, but she did not recognize him. Jesus said, "Woman, why are you crying? Who are you looking for?" Mary thought Jesus might be the gardener. She replied, "Sir, if you have taken Jesus away, tell me where you've put him, and I will go get him." Jesus said, "Mary." Mary realized who he was and said, "Teacher!" Jesus sent Mary to tell the other disciples that he was going back to the Father. Mary did what Jesus said, and she told the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." Meanwhile, some of the guards from Jesus' tomb went into the city and told the religious leaders everything that had happened. The leaders got together and made a plan. They gave the soldiers a lot of money and told them to lie about what they saw. "Say that Jesus' disciples came in the night and stole his body while you were sleeping," they said. The guards took the money and lied about Jesus' resurrection. Jesus died on the cross for our sins, but he didn't stay dead. God was pleased with Jesus' sacrifice and raised Jesus from the dead on the third day to reign as king over all creation. Jesus provides salvation from sin and the promise of eternal life.
Now arriving at the empty tomb station.
Oh, my favorite station. Let me explain why. The disciples and followers of Jesus were sad, angry, and hopeless seeing Jesus dying on the cross. After Jesus died, his body was moved to a heavily guarded tomb, which was where people laid the dead. But we know Jesus' death on the cross didn't take him by surprise. He told his disciples that he would rise from the dead. The greatest miracle, a true historical event, and a supernatural act of God. So, the tomb that used to represent death, sadness, hopelessness, is now an empty tomb that gives us hope, new life, and an eternal promise of love. Through his victory over sin and death, those who believe in him can find everlasting life through Jesus, God's Son. That's why this is my favorite station. As promised in every word of the Bible, the truth of Jesus Christ's victory became known first to his closest followers, and then was spread throughout the rest of the world. And now, after thousands of years, we are gathered here today on Easter to be reminded of the good news that is here for all of us to hear and experience today. And the Spirit of God that raised Christ from the dead was not just a once and done deal. In fact, that same Spirit is alive inside of those who say, "I believe," and have faith in Jesus, even still today. The miraculous power at work in the Son is still working within those who believe. So let's celebrate! Jesus Christ is risen, and Jesus is alive! Thanks for riding with us all month long on the Mariners Kids Bullet Train Express. We hope to see you back again soon. All aboard! Hey guys, Conductor Kate here. I've got a great verse for you, and it comes from the book of Revelation. And it goes like this: blessings and honor, glory and power be to the one seated on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever. Revelation 5:13b. Now let's stand up and say our verse all together on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Blessings and honor, glory and power be to the one seated on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever. Revelation 5:13b. So great. Now let's do it one more time. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Blessings and honor, glory and power be to the one seated on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever. Revelation 5:13b. Fantastic job. I'll see you guys next week.
Who could carry the
much for joining us today. I hope you had a great time and learned something too. Make sure to check out our Family Connect questions and discuss it with your, you guessed it, your family. Make sure to like and subscribe too. See you next weekend online or at one of our campuses. Bye!